What is up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to hop into a relic material farming guide so you're getting the most bang for your buck when you're spending your crystals, breaking down that gear, using your Cantina node energy to make sure that you're able to get all those characters to relic to go after those galactic legends and anything else that you're going out after in the game. So let's hop over and get started. But before we do, if this is your first time on the channel, be sure to hit that sub button if you enjoy the content for some more Galaxy of Heroes guides and videos in the future. All right, let's hop over and take a look at relic materials. The first ones that I want to look at are the ones that you get from farming Cantina node energy. And right off the bat, I recommend farming these with Cantina node energy. Don't spend crystals on these if you don't have to. You get a lot more just by doing your refreshes every day. Now, I know sometimes that you need that Cantina node energy, though, to be able to farm your character shards. So if you are going to spend crystals on any of these, I recommend doing this on the flawed signal data. This one has a pretty poor drop rate compared to the other two. It is expensive to purchase these. It's 1500 for 50 of these material pieces. But you do get probably two relic level increases out of this. So it's not a terrible purchase. And like I said, the drop rates on these are pretty poor. So if you're going to spend crystals, spend them there. You're going to get a lot more bang for your buck when it comes to that. Now for these other pieces, these are ones that you have to break down gear to be able to get, or you have to purchase these with crystals. Now, if you are going to purchase something with crystals, this one right here, I find that I do quite often because as a newer player in this game, I don't have a huge stockpile of the pieces needed for this, and there's nothing that I can upgrade to for these. If you look at these, it's just going to be just regular pieces that you're using here. Now, I do a lot of times just break these down, knock this up to 50 here, and you start getting quite a bit of pieces on that. But if you're gonna spend crystals on these, it's 500 for 100 of pieces of these. It's not terrible value if you start learning low on these. Now, for the bronzium wiring, you should never have to spend crystals or buy these. A lot of the pieces that you use to break down on this are stuff that you get from your daily challenges that you just get tons and tons of. So make sure that you're just using that gear to get that. Now for these next two, there are some great ways to get around the gear crunch to be able to get a lot of bang out of the gear pieces that you're using. It's really going to help you out. And for that, I want to hop over to these guides I found on Reddit. Big shout out to Gerbil23 for putting these together for the community. And the first thing that I want to look at is for these chromium transistors. It's going to give you a great way to use a useless character like Ugnaught to be able to craft these Mark 7 BAW armor mods. To be able to just really put yourself ahead as far as what you're spending gear-wise to get each one of these transistors. So what you want to do is level your Ugnaught up to gear level 5. You can do like level 40 on him, and that will where you can't even increase him past gear level 5. And this piece right here, you want to craft that. It's really, really cheap to make, and it's really cheap to farm these materials if you don't have to farm these, or if you don't have these materials. It's only 6 energy per chance on these, so it's a great way to farm up these pieces, and you end up getting 7 transistors every time that you craft one of these pieces, which is way, way cheaper than spending 1,000 crystals to get 25 or breaking down and throwing like 50 gear pieces at this. Highly recommend going this route. It's a great way to use Ugnaught. Set them as your favorite. You know, every time you need these, just go in, make these pieces, and you're gonna come out a lot better. Now, the next one after that is the heat sinks. And this one was one that I was familiar with, but it's something that you need to be doing if you're not familiar with it. So if you go to purchase one of these heat sinks, it's 1,000 crystals for 10, but you can use these Mark III holo projectors. I do know this is a piece that a lot of people need for gearing up their characters, but it is a great way to get a lot of bang for your buck when it comes to getting these heat sink materials for your relic. So it's 300 crystals to buy one of those. It's going to give you 10 of the heat sink farming materials. And this is another one that is really easy to just kind of farm if you have extra energy available. It's 8 energy on ship nodes to actually farm these holo projector pieces, and it's just a easy way to get 10 of these instead of spending a ton of crystals or using 50 of other pieces to be able to get this. So definitely be breaking these down into heat sinks when you need those. It's going to be the most efficient way to do that. Now, let's hop back to the game. For these other ones here, I recommend these. I use crystals on quite often just because when you're reliquing up characters, all this gear is something that you need to get past these gear 12 crunches. So I end up spending crystals quite a bit on these conductors. But if you're able to get these pieces right here, you do get quite a bit. You get 13 for one of these. This one does take quite a bit to actually make the piece. So I recommend using crystals here. At least it works well for me to save these pieces. So when I need to gear 12 up characters, I've got this stuff available. And then lastly, these right here are not purchasable. And usually with these, I just break down these pieces, throw it on 10 or 50. It takes 10 of these to get this last level going, which is not super terrible. So this one is just an expensive one to get through. You have to use the pieces there. But for this other one, for the conductor, like I said, a lot of times it's expensive to use crystals. It's $17.25 for 15. But for me, it's worked better just because I get a pretty decent crystal income every day. So if you got high crystal income, this is a way to go to kind of save out on those gear pieces that are kind of tough to farm, that sort of thing. So hopefully this was helpful for you. If you got some questions or some other tricks down below, be sure to do that. I will also leave a link to Gerbil's Guides down there so you can have those available. You can use your cup and you can use Ugnaught to be able to kind of craft those pieces that you need. And you're set, you're golden, you're going to be able to get a more bang for your buck from those materials that you're using every time. So thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next video.